all who come to keep the old ways. We are here to honour the gods and to keep the feast of Midsummer. Let us begin by remembering the Earth Mother. We welcome Jor, Mother of Thor, Daughter of Not. And ask your blessing. Bring bounty to your children in this time of change. Earth Mother, gaze on our work with gracious eyes. Bless our stead with harvest joy. We welcome Jor, Mother of Thor, Daughter of Not and Onar, from fertile fields. Near you near, and ask your blessing. Bring bounty to your children in this time of change. Earth Mother, gaze on our work with gracious eyes, and bless our stead with harvest joy.
Bailey! Hello. Yeah, police? Yeah, my dog's just found a body.
Morning, Neil.
Morning, Sergeant.
Hiya.
What are you doing?
I want him.
Sarge?
Oh, he's with me. Hi, Billy.
Helen? Hello, Grant sent me up. What you want me to do, just ask.
It's all this for me, if you want. Right, Neil, what we got?
Just give me a minute or two. It's a big one, is this?
You all right, Neil?
I'm fine. Why?
Can we have a look, please?
Male, long red hair, about 30 to 40, I reckon. Been dead about a week to 10 days.
Looks like that green tree activist, Jesus Trees. What's this round his neck?
You won't have many friends with that.
Are you sure you're all right, Neil?
Yes, thank you, Sergeant. It's the body decomposing before you continue to act like silly schoolboys.
If it's rotting that bad, surely it's been there a lot longer than a week.
Probably. I won't know till I've got the corpse back to the morgue.
Our murderer's got pretty big thighs if they're wearing this.
Morning, Your Lordship. About the papers we discussed. Your brother?
Oh, yes. Take a seat.
Unfortunately, since the attack and the head injury he sustained, he's lost his memory.
I see.
But it's not just that. He's now convinced he's got something to do with the English Civil War.
One of our ancestors, Captain David Grant, led his troops on behalf of the parliamentary forces against the royalists. You might not believe this, but Captain Grant's ghost still walks the hall on the grounds, you know.
Really?
Yes, really.
Look, he's going to have to stay with us for some time, so if he could just sign this.
We never really got on, you know, but I've always tried to do my best for him.
Oh, I know you did. I only wish we could have done more. But look, I'm busy with this murder in the woods, so I'm going to have to go. If that's all right with you.
Oh, certainly. I understand.
But thank you for your time.
Are you there? Yes.
Mr. Cromwell, you enjoy the fresh air? And I'll be back in 10 minutes once I've sorted Julius Caesar and Mr. Hitler out.
All right. Hello, Otto.
Who is this Otto you speak of? I am Oliver Cromwell. You would do well to remember that.
Very funny, Otto.
I am the Lord Protector, Oliver Cromwell. And I do not tolerate insolence from silly wenches.
Look, just because you're wearing a silly hat does not make you Oliver Cromwell. Stop being so stupid and tell me I can get the money that you owe me.
I am the Lord Protector, Oliver Cromwell. And I could have you put to death for your insolence, young wench.
How convenient. I don't mean the putting me to death bit. It won't work, Otto. I know you too well. I don't care what scam you got going on now. I just want my money.
Officer! Officer of the watch! I want this strumpet burned at the stake for heresy and witchcraft! Burn her! Burn her!
What? You really are no good for anything now. It's like I'm gonna have to chat up that pathetic David Grant after all. If his dad could be persuaded to drop dead, maybe it might not be all that bad. I don't think you are joking now. You really have lost it, you pathetic individual. Oh. And you've got a leak. It's disgusting. Alice, you there? We met up at the hall some time ago. You were going to hop in to take me out, if you remember.
Oh, yeah. Sorry about that.
It's okay. Look, I'm at a bit of a loss at the moment, and I just happened to see you passing, and I thought I'd be cheeky and take you up on that offer of a drink. If it's still on offer.
Yeah, definitely. I've just bought myself an old sports car. I need to go and take it out for a drive. Do you fancy coming along?
I love sports cars. My dad was really into them. So I'd love to.
Okay, great. It's in the barn by the hall. Shall we say 7 on Thursday?
Definitely.
Inquiries regarding that body that was found in the woods the other day.
Right, yeah, okay.
Is it okay if I just ask you a few questions?
Yeah.
All right, can I start with your name, please?
Alison Mitchell.
Alison Mitchell. You just bear with me 2 seconds.
Okay.
Sarge? Can we do this inside, miss?
Yeah, okay. Come in.
Hello, Miss Mitchell. Thanks for your time.
No problem.
I was just wondering if you knew a man who was known locally as Jesus Trees.
Sorry. Oh, yeah. One poor man.
Oh, so you did know him?
Well, no, just what I read in the papers.
All right. I understand that you've been in the woods fairly recently with the Sisters of the Red Garter.
Sisters of the Red Garter is just a local nickname for us, Sergeant. As well you know. Well, yeah, I was there about a week or so ago with other ladies from the Sister Rose Green Naturalist Society.
And what were you doing there, then?
Well, there's some very rare herbs and fungi in those woods that have to be gathered at night. That's all, Sergeant. Nothing sinister, I assure you.
Weren't the woods the scene of an horrific battle during the Civil War?
Well, yeah, they were. But long before that, there were a sacred meeting place for druids and those who practiced the Wiccan religion. There's some very ancient and powerful forces at work in those woods.
Right, yeah. Well, look, I'm more interested in the here and now, so is there anything you can tell us? I mean, did you see anything? Was there anything that stood out to you?
No, I'm afraid not. Look, I'm sorry, but I can't help you. Do you mind? Well, if there isn't anything else, I'm rather busy.
No, that's it for the moment. But we might need to speak to you again.
Okay.
Thank you.
How are you getting on down there?
Can't you do this yourself?
If I could bend down there myself, then I wouldn't have asked you to do it now, would I?
Open your legs a bit wider then. That's better. You can see it now. Oh,
That's it. Now you're getting there. A bit faster now. Backwards and forwards.
I thought you were different. You're a bloody sex maniac.
Bloody hell.
Ah. What was that?
Some nutter outside. They're gone now. Did you get it?
Unworthy mortals, daughters, do once again seek communion. Enter and fill us with your great and bountiful grace. Earth Mother guides our hands. Earth Mother guides our hands. Earth Mother, you honor us with your presence.
Something's calling.
Something is coming.
Earth
Mother?
Fools!
Great Spirit, please tell us, unworthy mortals, who are you?
I am Captain David Grant of the Parliamentary Forces.
Parliamentary Forces? That's the English Civil War.
Why have you summoned me?
We are sisters of the Earth Mother who practice the old religion in our sacred place in Hollow's Wood. There's been a murder there.
How dare you desecrate my burial ground?
Great Spirit, we mean no disrespect.
Would it be okay if we said we were very sorry and we won't do it again?
No.
I thought so.
What we must do to appease you, Great Spirit?
Find a person desecrating my burial ground, or you all die. You will all die.
Oh, it's awful. It smells like... I don't even know what it smells like. It stinks.
Check under the wheels of the car. We might have hit something.
Oh, it's absolutely disgusting.
There's nothing there. Come on, let's get back in the car.
Check your boot.
I'm not opening the boot.
It's definitely coming from the boot. Open the boot right now.
It's locked.
Open the boot.
There's nothing in the boot.
There is something in the boot because you won't open it.
Don't blame me, right?
What the hell is that?
Dwarf.
And what is it doing in the boot of your car? Is it dead?
Of course it's dead. I wouldn't have a live one in it now, would I?
Where did you get it from?
It was an accident. I hit it last night whilst it was up by the woods. I thought I'd get rid of it today. In fact, you can help me bury it now.
I am not burying a dwarf. It's like hitting a dog or something. Don't you have to tell the police?
Well, probably. But are you going to help me tell the police how that got in my boot? Plus, I don't think dwarves are that common these days. So that's going to cause an almighty uproar while PC Plod figures out where it lives and what its social security number is.
This is not real. I'm getting back in the car.
Mother, grant us the vision to see what is wrong and wisdom to put things right. The mists are creeping. I see a man with red hair in the ancient burial ground. I see someone behind him. Oh no, he's dead?
Sounds like that Jesus Trees chap the police just found.
Perhaps. Wait. The ball is misting up again. I see car headlights and something in the road trying desperately to get away. Ah! Oh no! It's gone!
What did you see?
Dwarf, crown prince weirdo, killed by car. Unfortunately, your son was driving the car.
David, you bloody idiot. For the dwarfs to run over, you have to hit a royal one. There'll be a heavy price to pay for this. But far, far worse. If dwarf royalty's wandering this world, the portal must be wide open.
It would seem so.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes.
Are you looking for something particular?
Garters. You know, it's the legs.
Right, okay. Any particular colour?
Red. They've got to be red.
Okay, well, we don't stock a lot of red. But I do have these. That one there, and that one there. Is it actually the colour, sir, or is it just the texture?
No, I was just wondering if you got anything a bit bigger.
They are elasticated, sir.
Yeah. Actually, I was after something a bit like this.
Can I?
By all means.
Ah, right. What you actually want isn't a garter. There we are. I've only got one in red. Is this.
You sure? What about these things here?
Well, on yours they've been cut off.
Right, well, I'll take it then.
Okay, well that'll be £20 then, please.
That much?
£20.
Never mind.
Shall I put it in a bag for
you? No, thanks. I'll just take it as it sits. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Come on, Jack. Come on, Jack. You don't want another fitness course, do you? So have we got on with that garter?
Well, that's the murder weapon that we found around Jesus Tree's neck.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I just brought from the shop this morning.
Well, come on. Don't keep me in suspense.
Funny you should say that, Sarge, because this isn't a garter. It's a suspender belt. If you look closely, you can see where the clips that all the stockings on have been cut off.
So? Looks like somebody's trying to frame the Sisterhood. Come on, I'll take you back to the Nick. Right, we're somewhere around here that I hit him, so it seems fitting to bury him here.
Look, I'm not looking to get arrested with you, so let's just dump that thing and get the hell out of here.
I can't just dump him. We have to bury him at least. But it won't take long.
Over there. Dog walkers. They're coming over here.
Oh, it looks like Billy Bloke and his mate that do odd job stuff for my dad. Quick, come here.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
What a reason to be here, romance.
Really? Dog. I'll give you a reason. If you ever try that again, that'd be the very least of what I'd do to you.
David? Okay.
Fine, Billy. No problem. You doing something for my dad?
Yeah, we're just checking edges and fence. Been a lot of stuff getting through lately, you know?
Oh, I know. Anyway, just checking the countryside and having a chat with Alice.
Yeah, so yeah. Didn't particularly look like that to me, but that's what you say. Anyway, I'll be off. Oh. Your dad says Otto's escaped from Lorne Bin. So if you see him, beware.
Has he indeed? Right, well, if you don't mind.
Touch her affection. Slap in the face. Are you sure she likes you?
Rob! Get up.
See you later.
Exactly what sort of country bumpkins are those two, then?
Just leave it. Stand watch, then.
Dead, didn't you?
Yes.
Well, in that case, I've got some news for you, because it isn't. Well, at least we can't get arrested now.
What?
You didn't kill it, dummy. It's no big deal, really. Apart from her in the sink, of course. Don't know if it'll take a bath.
Let's get out of here.
Dwarf come to life and run off, did it?
Well, yeah. As a matter of fact, it did. But how did you know?
Oh, Sister Isabella saw you hit it with your car in the crystal ball.
Why didn't you say something?
You were going to be told the full story at the masquerade evening next month. That is family tradition, but circumstances overtook that. When I missed you last night and again this morning, I sent Billy off to find you and collect the dwarf if you dumped it. As luck would have it, you tried to bury it within the circle. So knowing what would happen, Billy just left you to it.
The circle?
The magical beings can only live within a 2-mile radius of Hollow's Wood. You must have knocked him out as they can't be killed in that area. Then when he drove outside the circle, he just froze. So you thought he was dead.
I've seen these beings on and off all my life. And you just told me that we were blessed, and that I shouldn't tell anyone.
It's a long story, and involves a sisterhood as well as one of our ancestors, Captain David Grant. It all started in 1644 at the Battle of Marston Moor. Captain David Grant, who you were named after, was part of the Siege of York, and was sent to round up resistance in the surrounding villages. He got in a fight with the Royalists at the village of Long Marston on the 2nd of July.
Fire!
What apparition is this? What sorcery? If you be the devil come to take my soul, know, sir, I shall fight you till my dying breath before you drag me to hell.
Foolish mortal, I am neither demon nor deity. I am the Green King.
I have renounced kings. I'll have none of them. I'll bend the knee for no man.
Brave words for one now past life.
And dead? Already?
Spilling of blood on sacred ground, wherein the ancient magical kingdom of Green Gold lies, has opened a portal between the two worlds. As penance, you and your future generations must guard this portal to keep my subjects safe.
But my family, I'll never see them again. How will they know what to do?
By the power of the Green Gold. You shall see and hear them again, as you instruct them of my will. And your lineage will be provided for by the partaking of the ancient gold, each according to their needs. Under your counsel, your eldest shall be Grand Master, aided by all the women born within the circle. But should he or his family take more gold than their needs, then his life shall be forfeit for the next in line to serve, and the ancient gold to be renewed. Do you understand?
I will not fail.
Come unto me now, old soldier. You have much to learn and see before your watch begins.
Hello, Alice. Surprised to see me?
Not really. I heard you're out. Not mad then.
Well, that's a matter of opinion.
So what was all that Oliver Cromwell stuff about?
You are so gullible. Look, it was just an alibi. Security at that hospital is so lax, I can just come and go as I please.
You killed that man in the woods, Jesus Trees.
It's very, very perceptive of you, Alice.
Right, I want my money or I'm telling the police.
Well, I don't have it on me right now. Don't worry. I do have this. Shiny gold coin. And this one, I pulled from the cold, dead fingers of the late, unlamented Mr. Jesus Trees. You see, he found out where they were buried and I couldn't have that, so he had to go. And there'll be plenty more when my brother finally meets the Red Garter killer in person.
You mean to kill him?
Of course I mean to kill him. Look, I tried to be nice. Really, I did. But it's his own fault, really. It should all be mine. The gold, the hall, the title. It's my birthright. You see that, don't you, Alice?
Surely they'll know it was you.
That's the clever part. Because I'm going to kill my brother in the exact same way as a poor, unfortunate Mr. Trees, garrotted by a Red Garter while he's tied up in the vestry, waiting for the stupid sisterhood ritual to put all the little green people back.
So you let them out?
Of course I let them out. How the hell else was I supposed to get my brother on his own with the sisterhood in the next room? Look, I'm going back to the hospital now. And then I'm going to sneak out at the weekend for the masquerade evening. They'll get the blame. And it'll all be mine. It's genius. It's genius. I am a genius, aren't I, Alice?
Yes, of course. Anything you say, Otto.
Good girl. And once my brother's dead, you'll get your money. And a lot more besides.
Ah!
Hello? This is... Oh, I can't say that. Hello? This is Nicole. The old man is going to get it in the vestry. You'd better come quick.
Who are you? Who is it? Is that you? Who is it?
Super. Oh. Five of
Let him go now!
No, it's too late.
It's
You don't understand. He's going to get rid of all the fairy people and the little green man.
He's going to take all the gold for himself. No one knows where the fairies is, you chummy. Take him outside, call for transport.
Come
on. I'll be out in a minute. Lucky we got an anonymous call. Could have been dead.
No, Otto didn't tie me up. It's a game. It's for the party tonight. Like a murder mystery night.
You sure?
I'm quite sure. Oh, there is one thing you can do for me. If you could just pop that rag back over my head, that would be absolutely super.
You want me to put this back over your head?
Thank you.
You did not just... all of them.
Alison, I thought that was you. I'm sorry for cancelling at short notice. Something came up. But the car's on the road now, so perhaps you'd like to go out sometime?
You must be joking. I know what comes up in that car of yours. Besides, I've got myself a real man now. Rob? Rob? Let's get some air before that Alice slapper comes over.
Come on, let's wait.
So, what exactly happens tonight?
Well, tonight is a unique event. David Grant is going to become the new Grandmaster. But first, we need to get rid of the old one.
What do you mean, get rid of?
We sacrifice him. We can't have two Grandmasters now, can we?
Sacrifice him? How?
These, of course. You didn't think they were for doing your nails with, did you?
And, everyone's all right with that, are they?
Of course they are. Shame it's not his brother Otto. Stupidly let him owe me money for a business venture. Still, I have a strong feeling fate will intervene with Mr. Otto Black tonight.
Billy, thank God you're here.
David.
You have to help.
What's up?
It's Dad. He's in terrible danger.
Danger?
They're going to kill him. We have to find him and warn him.
Oh, look, just calm yourself down. It'll be all right. I'll get some help. Rob?
Yes, mate.
All right.
Come on, then. Don't just stand there. Do something. Do something. What the hell do you think you're doing?
They got me, you pleb.
Pleb?
Charming. Oh, God.
You're in on this together, aren't you? You're mad.
Help! Help!
He said, shut it.
I've told you it'll be all right. Stop shouting. Stop struggling. It's just your dad's last night, that's all.
Dad, run! Dad! Run! Get out! They're gonna kill you!
The initiate will be silent and contrite.
But Dad!
Sisterhood of the Red Garter, in the name of the Green King and Mother Earth, are you willing to share and pass on the penance, as did your mothers and their mothers before them?
We are willing.
Are you willing?
My penance is served. My time is done.
Your penance is served. Your time is done.
Your penance is served. Your time is done.
Your time is done.
Your time is done.
Your time is done. It is done.
Is it over? Dad, I thought you were. I thought they had.
Billy. I thought I told you to tell him the ritual was only symbolic.
Oh yeah, I did that, didn't I? I just thought I'd liven it up a bit. Sorry.
In case anybody got too enthusiastic.
Yeah, right.
Right, time for a drink, I think.
I'm in.
Transport was coming in 2 minutes. That was 3 hours ago.
It's here now.
Do your feet go to any of them shoes? You could have kissed parties. You are a clown.
Just shut up!
You honour us with your presence.
No, that all went wrong.
Fucking hell.
She went.
Fucking hell. It's coming.
Earth Mother. Great Spirit, please tell us unworthy the...
Right, okay.
I'm not opening the boot.
It's definitely coming from the boot. Open the boot right now.
It's locked.
Open the boot.
There's nothing in the boot.
There is something in the boot because you won't open it.
Never mind.
David!
Keep going, keep going. Now do it again, please. Sorry.
I'm stuck.
Stop, because Alice can't stop laughing.
Did you see that?
that?
They're maybe more frustrated, actually. I was quite...
Should we do that again?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's...
Can you, like, can actually, when he actually gets up, can you, like, then...
Right.
I'll
right.
tell you what's throwing it is down when we get there. He was up, and he went down fart, and then he got up fart.
No, that's right. He starts down.
Starts down. Up fart, down fart.
No.
No.
No. There's a down fart, there's an up fart, and then the last one is a down fart.
Yeah.
Yeah, gets up farts, down.
It's not how it was, but it was fart, fart. It says, gets up, fart. And then I say, yeah. All right, because I'm waiting for him to get up and fart before I deliver my line, because that's what it says.
Yeah, yeah, that's it, yeah. But he has to get up, farts, and then you say, all right, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, but he's down.
Yeah,
yeah, no, he hasn't
got up. He hasn't got up yet.
So, big one is this.
Just give me a minute or two. It's a big one, is this, right? Which farts, right?
Yeah, but
Billy
it should
laughs,
be up.
He gets up, you get up after Billy laughs, and we fart again. That's it.
Nah, come
so
on.
So, one down, one up, and one down.
Then look, he says, are you okay, Neil?
Say that again. Just repeat it again. Everybody listen.
Right. What we got, Neil? So is he standing up or down then?
He's down.
I'm down then.
Right, so I'm
then
coming. I'm coming from
minute.
Here.
Just
it's
give me a minute.
It's a bigger than this. Fart!
Yeah. Just ha ha ha.
What we got now?
Get up!
Just
fart.
Give me a minute or two.
Bloody hell.
Ah, it's a bigger than this.
And another fart. Right,
you
brilliant.
Say, are you
alright,
Neil?
Yeah.
You are you alright?
I'm fine.
I'll go with that.
Right, and then we get. Can we have a look, please? At which case, you don't get fully down. You go down like that, lift the thing, and lift it back, and stand back up. Right?
Yeah.
Male.
Redhead, been dead, whatever. Week to 10 days.
Week to 10 days.
Looks like that green activist. Jesus, trees. What's that thing round his neck? Get back
down. Get
back down. Bloody hell. Right.
You know what? How many mates were that?
And you lot learnt the chuffing
lines,
did you?
I'm here, I'm here.
It's the stage direction we're missing.
Yeah, that comes in with the lines, boys. Sorry, did you not know?
Do have this. That's not just dropping it, is it? Shiny gold coin. One of many. Bollocks.
Yep.
One of many bollocks. Hello, Alice. Surprised to see me? Very surprised.
Oh, right up until then, that was good. Alright, fill it up. Wherever it is, and have another go.
Yeah, but benches weren't nice.
Bailey.
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 Hey.
Alice.
Hey.
Is that?
Yeah.
We met up at the hall some time ago. You were going to hop into that to take me out, if you remember.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Sorry about that.
Okay. Look, I'm at a bit of a loss at the moment, and I just happened to see you passing and thought I'd be cheeky and take you up on that offer of a drink. It's still on offer.
Yeah. Coming from the car, I knew where it was.
Yeah, you heard it. Just kept going.
Was that any better?
Yes, much better.
Yeah.
That's exactly where you should be.